Docket review is James.
Yes, Mr. President, now we will move on to the docket review. Consent agenda item number one, ordinance number 2012-192, to amend reordaining chapter 98, article 13, division 1 of the city code concerning business license incentive program for qualifying businesses for the purpose of exempting new businesses that locate within the city from paying business, professional, and occupational license taxes for a period not exceeding 2 years.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. 2 weeks ago, I asked if there's any questions out there, every single paper, in an effort to speed this up. If you have a question, please let me know. Otherwise, we'll allow Mr. Clerk to simply read through.
Okay, item number two, ordinance number 2012-233, to erect an all-way stop sign at the intersection of North Shepherd Street and Stewart Avenue. Item number three, ordinance number 2013-1.
Mr. Clerk, if you wouldn't mind, let them know if it's continued or if it is staying on consent.
Okay.
Thank you.
Item number two is continued till February the 25th. Item number three, ordinance number 2013-1, to authorize the CAO to execute a lease between Catab Ventures, Inc. as leasehold and the City of Richmond as leasing for the purpose of providing a temporary site for the East End Library at 3001 Non-RO, Unit C and Unit B, for a period of 6 months beginning February 1, 2013. As pertaining to the consent. Item number four, ordinance number 2013-2, to amend and reordain City Code Section 110-37 concerning taxicab rates for the purpose of providing that for a trip originating at Richmond International Airport, the rate shall be $10 while the charge registered on the meter of whichever's rate. That paper will change the consent. Item number five, ordinance number 2013-3, to authorize the CAO to accept $50,000 from the Virginia Department of Emergency Management and to appropriate an increase to fiscal year 2012-2013 special fund budget for the Department of Fire and Emergency Services for the purpose of the Richmond MSA Public Outreach and Education Project. That figures to retain on the consent agenda. Item number six, ordinance number 2013-4, to authorize a special use of property known as 1815 and 1817 East Franklin Street for the purpose of a multi-family dwelling with up to 13 dwelling units. That paper will be moved to the regular agenda and continue until February the 25th.
Madam Vice President.
Stanford?
Yes. Are we going to discuss the sign? Are we going to move it or maybe ask questions now?
If there are questions, Mr. Miller, I will assume that you we will address those now. It will, the paper will be continued February 25th.
Okay. If I could just have one quick question to staff to get back with me. I'm not sure who is financing this development, but just for conflict of interest purposes, if I wanted to get back with me as to whether Virginia House Development Authority is financing this, that would be appreciated.
That's your question, Mr. Chairman. That's your question as related to the topic of potential conflict.
And let's see, can someone from planning staff get back with me on that?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Item number seven, ordinance number 2013-5, to authorize special use of property known as 3600 Forestdale Avenue for the purposes of permitting live entertainment and an outdoor dining area. That paper is retained on the consent agenda. Item number eight, ordinance number 2013-8, to amend ordinance number 2009-102-114, adopted June the 22nd, 2009, which authorized special use of property known as 508 Libby Avenue for office use with accessory parking to authorize office use in the existing basement. And that paper is retained on the consent agenda. Item number nine, ordinance number 2013-9, closed to public use and travel, a portion of West 24th Street located north of Perry Street between West 22nd and West 24th Street, and consisting of 2,584,000 square feet. That paper contained on the consent agenda. Item number four, ordinance number 2013-2, to amend and reopen any city code section 110-37 concerning tax cap rates.
I'm sorry.
That's not the item number 10. Ordinance number 2013-11, to authorize a special use of property known as 4030 Metcalf Avenue for the purpose of permitting an outdoor dining area and expansion of the existing building. That paper is contained on the consent agenda. Item number 11, ordinance number 2013-12, to amend and reopen chapter 102, article 6, provision 1 of the state code by adding thereon a new section number 102-246, and to amend and reopen city code section 102-243 concerning parking violations and penalties for non-compliance with certain parking requirements, both for the purpose of requiring that curbside wheels of vehicles parked on streets parallel to a curb shall be no more than 12 inches from such curb, and imposing a fine for violation of such requirements.
Madam Vice President, just a point of clarification. This needs to be amended, so we'll be making that amendment later this evening, and then it will be continued for February 25th, correct?
Yes, I was going to add that page to be amended and continue to February the 25th. Item number 12, ordinance number 2013-18, to authorize the CAO to accept funds in the amount of $135,185 from the United States Department of Homeland Security and to appropriate the increase in fiscal year 2012-2013 special fund budget for the Department of Fire and Emergency Services for the purpose of providing for the purchase of computer hardware and software to increase critical information sharing and collaboration efforts between the city and other entities at the Port of Richmond. And generally within the city of Richmond. That paper is retained on the consent agenda. Item number 13, ordinance number 2013-19, to amend ordinance number 2012-188-2013-3, adopted January the 28th, 2013, which ordained a new city code, section 98-249.1, imposing a moratorium on acceptance of applications from nonprofit organizations for exemption from real or tangible personal property taxation for the purpose of temporarily extending the deadlines for the completion of the property tax exemption by designation committee's review of applications for tax exemption by designation and the deadline by which ordinances exempting property from taxation must be introduced before the deadline set forth in the city code section 98-248. That paper is retained on the consent agenda. For appointments and reappointments, we have one item, that's item number 14, resolution number 2013-R19, to appoint Carol A. Murray as a member of the Queen City Commission. That paper is retained on the consent agenda. On the regular agenda, we have item number 15, ordinance number 2012-29, to authorize special use of property known as 122. Tensville Lane for the purpose of authorizing a lot split that would result in an additional lot restricted to the principal use as set forth in the R1 single family residential zoning district. That paper is going to be continued until February the 25th. Item number 16, ordinance number 2012-168, to amend and reordain ordinance number 2001-308-305, adopted October the 22nd. 2001, which authorized a special use of property known as 2501 Monument Avenue for the purpose of a museum for architecture with outdoor events, a reception facility, and an print book dealer in a lodging unit to authorize the expansion of the number of types of permitted events on certain terms and conditions. That paper is continued until March 11th. And item number 17, resolution number 2013-R8. To establish a policy that when one patron of a proposal that would result in a reduction on the existing revenue source must also identify an alternative revenue source to offset the proposed reduction. Number two, proposals that would result in a reduction on the existing revenue source must be introduced only on the city's annual budget process. That paper is continued until March 11th. That completes our docket review.
Thank you, Mr.
Madam Vice President, I move that the council go into closed meeting pursuant to section 2.2-3711A1, being Virginia Freedom of Information Act, for the purpose of discussing some or all of the assignment forms for compensation of the city auditor's clerk appointees.
So your second, Mr. Hilbert, all in favor?
Aye.
Any votes? Any extensions? Seeing none, but Eric, we're going to close session.